Hi, this is Fran with Little Windows. Let me show you how I made these using photos on top of decorative materials like brightly colored candies and texture film. These projects start with these beautiful metal rings. Each set includes 4 rings, 4 sheets of resin backer film, and 4 adhesive cork backs in case you want to make coasters. These are beautifully shiny and a great size. The first thing to do before putting resin in any metal piece is to wipe it with isopropyl alcohol. This will remove any oils or dirt from the surface so the resin has the best chance to bond. The resin backer film has a nice stiffness to it, so it won't leave any wrinkles or crinkles in your project. Peel off the protective sheet and hold on to that. You'll use it as a dust cover while your project's set up. You want to make sure your surface is level and make sure the ring is stuck down well. I'm using Brilliant Resin. This is the safest epoxy you'll find, and I'm working in small batches. Even so, you want to be sure to have good ventilation and fresh air in your space. If you have chemical sensitivities, if you're mixing larger batches, making bigger projects, or you use resin a lot, make sure to protect yourself with a vapor mask or respirator and some gloves. It's a little chilly in here today, and my part A has thickened up. I'm going to warm it up a bit before I add part B so that it blends more easily and bubbles can rise and pop. Before you pour your first layer, let your resin thicken up a bit. This will help prevent leaks in case your surface or your rings aren't perfectly even. These brightly colored candy bits will look great behind this photo, in a coaster or an ornament. I've mixed up a batch of resin, and I'll pour a thinnish layer into my ring. This should flow across by itself to fill the bottom of the ring. Start sprinkling in your candy bits. Every so often, I'll hold my photo silhouette up against the ring. This helps guide my candy placement. If the resin isn't flowing all the way, just use your mixing wand to nudge it along. I printed this photo on my inkjet using special photo paper for resin. It's waterproof so it won't bleed or run. Place it where you want, push it down so it sticks to the resin. Now you can continue to arrange your little candy bits. Take the protective sheet that came from your resin backer film, stick it down in one corner, arch the sheet up, and stick it down in the opposite corner. And you've made a perfect dust cover. Wait at least 4 hours between each layer. Mine's been sitting about 12 hours. And I'm ready to pour my top layer to protect my photo. Because these candies were sticking up, I ended up doming up this piece. That means the resin's a little higher than the edge of the ring. When your resin is close to or above the edge of the ring, you won't be able to use this protective sheet as a dust cover. You can use the clear box that these rings come in, or any kind of protective cover, to keep dust from settling on your piece. After 10 to 15 minutes, check for bubbles. I just lift these out with my mixing wand. Let it set for 12 hours before handling to avoid fingerprints. Ooh, this piece looks great from the front and the back. Now I'll peel off the resin backer film. Because it leaves no residue on my resin piece, it's still completely sticky. Clean off the little bits and I can use this again. This is such a fun little piece. Originally, I wanted to use this as a coaster. I won't be able to set a mug or a cup on top of this because some of the candies are sticking up out of the resin. You can see them here from the side. So instead, I'll use this as an ornament. I can either put it in a little stand or add a jumbo pinch bale so I can hang it. Let me show you how I made this cute little paperweight. Starting with a gold ring, I took a piece of texture film from our jumbo Dichro-ISH film pack, crinkled it up and then smoothed it flat, and used this pen, which doesn't work very well, to trace a line around the center. Cut around that line and it fits right in the bottom of my ring. Use a fresh piece of no residue resin backer film. Rub it down so it's nice and stuck. And pour your first layer of resin. I only need a small amount of resin in the base for the first layer. Now add the texture film. You can use your fingers to smooth it, but once the resin starts coming up around the edges, it's better to use your mixing wand. What I'm doing is working out any air pockets that got trapped beneath the film. I'll add some resin on top and spread that around to make a nice smooth layer. Your mixing wand can be used over and over again. Wait at least 4 hours before pouring the next layer. I want to show you what it looks like when Brilliant Resin gets a little cold. Part A will thicken up. This makes it more difficult for it to blend thoroughly and for bubbles to rise and pop. It's much easier to work with when it's warm, and there's a couple of ways that you can heat it up. I measured out my part A and warmed it in my microwave for 7 to 10 seconds, and you can see the consistency is much thinner. I've added my part B, and now I'll blend. I'll pour my second layer. If you're making a coaster, you don't want to fill these all the way to the top. By having the metal ring stick up around the edge, you can catch condensation coming off your cups and glasses before it spills onto your table. And again, I've printed this image on special photo paper for resin, so I don't have to seal it before I put it in resin. So slide in your photo and press it down to the bottom. Cover it up and let it rest for 10 minutes. Sometimes the things we put in resin can float up, especially if there's any air trapped underneath. So use your mixing wand to push the photo down against the base, squishing out any bubbles. Cover it up and let it rest for another 10 minutes. Sometimes it takes a while for bubbles to rise. So cover this up and check it again in about 10 minutes. See this grouping of tiny bubbles? That means there was an air pocket underneath the photo that was slowly working its way out. I can either use my mixing wand to lift these out, or you can use a heat gun on a low setting. Make sure it's not too hot. That does the trick. I'm adding another element to this piece, these pretty little hammered metal hearts, and I'll use my tweezers to put them in. You could just stick them in any which way. At first, I thought I'd have a random pattern, but then that really bothered me. So I went back in and moved them around with my mixing wand. You can see the resin is thickening up, but I still have plenty of time to move these right where I want them. For fine-tuning, I'll use a straight pin. We'll cover this up and let it set for 12 hours to fully harden. Oh, she's so cute! The cutest puppy in the land! I really like how this came out, and how the texture film sparkles from the front and the back. I'll peel off the resin backer film, which has still got all its adhesive, so I can replace the cover sheet and use it again. The back of this piece is super shiny with no residue. If your ring or your surface aren't completely flat, a little bit of resin can escape, and that's what happened here. But this is easy to fix. Just bend it away from the ring and either peel it off or use scissors to trim right around and make a nice smooth edge. I can make this into a coaster by adding the self-adhesive cork backing that comes with the rings, but I think I'd rather have this sitting on my desk. There's so many things you can do with these shiny metal rings. Try a marbling technique, or add metallic stickers for an elegant set. You can add anything you'd like. These are deep enough for multiple layers and work beautifully with alcohol inks. For supplies and help with your resin projects, go to little-windows.com.